You don't need me to tell you the last 9 days have been unprecedented in the world of politics, starting with an assassination attempt against former President Trump. Days later, he accepted the Republican nomination for president and revealed his running mate, Ohio Senator J.D. Vance.
Then yesterday, President Joe Biden announced he was dropping out of the 2024 election and throwing his support to his vice president, Kamala Harris, at the Democratic presidential nominee. In just a few minutes, I'll be speaking with two High Point University students who were at the RNC last week and are going to the DNC in August.
Yeah, but first we are getting some insight from their political science professor, Dr. Brandon Lenore, who got the yellow tie memo today. I appreciate that. Thanks for being here.
Yes.
So it's been such a wild few days. Were you surprised to hear Biden's dropping out yesterday?
Actually, I wasn't. I think that when the drumbeat started after the debate, fundraisers and politicians were starting to pull their support, I thought it was a matter of time. I actually thought that it might happen a little bit earlier. I thought the announcement might come on Friday after the Republican National Convention wrapped up. But Sunday, he made his announcement.
If you don't mind, I'm going to have you turn your microphone off only because we're getting some really bad feedback from it.
Yeah, no, not a problem.
And so we're just going to pull it off my microphone.
Okay.
So feel free to just, yeah, I'll just take that off right there.
Very good.
Perfect. It was very distracting.
Sorry.
It's not your fault at all. So, as you know, he threw his support behind Kamala Harris. Is that enough for her to earn the nomination?
Well, the nomination, the delegates are all pledged to Joe Biden. And the Biden administration vetted all of the pledged delegates. So they're already predisposed to support Kamala Harris and Joe Biden. So it gives her a leg up. She's clearing the field right now in bringing in endorsements from different politicians that might have been a challenge for her. So it's starting to look like the path is clearing for her to get the nomination.
So in your opinion, you think that it seems as though the Democrats have kind of avoided a worst case scenario when it comes to a contested convention.
Well, clearly the Democrats didn't want to have it all of their dirty laundry aired on national television. They want this convention to be a smooth event. And I think that with the efforts that are going in to trying to whip up the votes for Vice President Kamala Harris, that they're going to be able to make it go as smoothly as possible.
Obviously, you've seen the short list for potential running mates, and we've seen that Governor Cooper's name is on that list. How do you see this playing out?
Well, it comes down to the electoral map. Who's going to bring more to the ticket? So you have the governor from North Carolina, you have the governor from Pennsylvania, a senator from Arizona, and a governor from Kentucky, that's kind of in the mix. I think that each of them bring different aspects, and it really comes down to where the Harris team thinks that they're going to be the weakest to bring in somebody from that region to try and shore up those votes.
And so do you think that North Carolina is purple enough that they could really use Governor Cooper to try to win this state?
I think it's possible. Right now, with the gubernatorial race that's highly contested, as well as a presidential race, North Carolina can go either direction. And if Roy Cooper is on the ballot, that could be enough to maybe push it to the blue column.
Now, if you're the Trump campaign, how do you shift your focus to Harris and what do you target?
So I think they've already done that. They've pivoted. They're now really focusing on her. I think what they're going to try and do is hang all of the negative issues that happened during the Biden administration onto her. She can't really have it both ways. You either take credit for the good things and take the blame for the bad things, or you have to distance yourself from all of it. So the economy, specifically inflation and the border, are going to be issues that they're going to try and hit her on.
So we should be expecting to hear a lot about those two issues over the coming months.
I anticipate that those are going to be the salient issues that are going to be most talked about.
All right, Dr. Lenore, thank you for your insight. Appreciate it. Yeah. Sydney.
All right, well, High Point University students attended the RNC last week, including Kyle Brierley and Jack Roush. So we're going to start here with Jack. Talk a little bit about your experience at the RNC and, of course, the overall atmosphere.
So I was working as a runner for CNN at the RNC, but of course, because of the attempted assassination attempt on Trump, my role was kind of diminished. So did runner duties and was running stuff around, walking different anchors, their booth they needed to. but mainly I was just kind of there, and I get to experience the convention through a role of like not being a delegate, which is pretty interesting to see.
Yeah, absolutely. And Kyle, you were there as well, so go ahead and talk a little bit about your experience.
So my experience was the same as Jack's. I was supposed to be driving people around and acting as like a shuttle service and helping out with the camera crew and just basic tasks like that. But after the unfortunate events that took place on Saturday, my job got diminished also. So basically, I was doing simple tasks for CNN, such as running coffee, running food, helping prepare the food. If anyone had any other tasks, such as handing out orders or if anything needed to be changed, I was right there. I was the right-hand man.
Yeah, and sticking with you, you're also attending the Democratic National Convention. So what are you looking forward to most in August?
So my main point of view would be if the security will remain the same, because obviously what happened on Saturday, I wasn't able to notice a shift in security because there was already so much security as it was. And we had gotten there Friday, and I had walked around the event Friday, and they were just putting up the gates and doing a security sweep. And after that, the whole place was locked down. You couldn't go anywhere without seeing Secret Service or cops. And I'm just curious on how in Chicago, if it'll be any different.
All right. Well, Jack and Kyle, thank you both for your insight. Let's toss it back to Chad for our final question.
Yeah, Sydney, thank you. So, you know, you've taken these kids, students, to the RNC, DNC this year. I imagine you've done so many other things in the past. I can't even imagine what it's like for these students to see this just historic pivotal moments in the last couple of weeks, and then knowing what will come for the DNC or the RNC, DNC, excuse me.
Yes. Well, the convention cycle is shaping up to be historic, obviously, with the attempt on Donald Trump's life and then the potential for a brokered convention. These students are getting a front row seat to history. They're going to be telling their grandkids about the time that they were at the national conventions in 2024. So it's a life-changing event. Both of them are going to be historic, and it's wonderful that we're able to give the students this opportunity.
For those of you at home that don't know this, I actually went with Dr. Lenore and his group of students for President Trump's inauguration years ago. I mean, just these types of experiences for students, you really can't show this or teach this in the classroom.
Well, it's experiential learning. It takes the lessons out of the classroom and it lets the students apply their knowledge into the field. So going to a convention and being able to work as a runner for a national convention is a great experience, because it touches on all of the key majors that went on the trip with political science, journalism, electronic media, and event management. They got a little bit of something for their profession.
That is really cool. Dr. Lenore, thank you for your time. I appreciate it, and we will be right back.